Adding comments to your app can significantly boost user engagement, but many people don't do this because they're unsure about how to add them. That's why we're going to explore how you can add this feature into your Glide app. This video is part of our Complete Guide to Glide Apps course inside the member area of No Code MBA. And the course is created by Oscar Brooks. Now, many developers struggle when it comes to implementing comments effectively. So stick around as Oscar takes you through step-by-step how to seamlessly integrate comments into your Glide app.
The next thing to do is, I think, introduce some comments, some form of comment stroke chat functionality into this app so that within a given to-do, the family can discuss in more detail. So within our data, as per usual, before we build anything in the UI, we're going to introduce a new table of comments. So let's introduce a new table called comments. And the comments table is going to look roughly like this. We're going to have a message, we're going to have a to-do ID. Now, this is really important because without this, Glide is never going to know which to-do a given comment is associated with, because of course they're all in the same table. So we're going to automatically include, when we add comments, the ID of the to-do so that all the comments appear where they're supposed to in terms of in the right task. So we're going to add in a to-do ID as a text column, and we are then going to add in the user email. This is how we're going to identify who actually submitted the comment, who added the comment. We're going to introduce the user, going to have a user relation. That is going to be a relationship where the value in user email matches the value in user's email. Okay. And then we're going to also have a user nickname, which we'll set up in a second, and a user photo, which we'll set up again in just a second. One other thing we're going to need is a timestamp, so when the comment was made. And that is going to be a basic date time column. And we're going to need the time this time so we can be really specific. Glide does something really cool, and it displays just now and X number of minutes ago, which you'll see. So I think that's everything we need in our comments table. So the next thing we're going to do is, in our layout, in a to-do, we're going to introduce the comments component down here, and we'll have it as the chat view. And let's introduce a container and pop the comments in there. And again, I'm just going to set the container as a card background, so it puts them in this box like this. It's a personal preference thing. I like it. And we're going to make that blue. That looks much better. Great. So our comments are going to pull from the new comments table. And we're going to save the text into message, which is perfect. The text itself is going to message. The timestamp is going to be pulled from timestamp itself. The author photo. In fact, let's do these first. So we're going to save. This is where we write information into the table so that we make sure we're capturing everything we need to. So the to-do ID is going to come from the row ID. And these values here are all being pulled from the screen that we're currently on. So it's the row ID. The user email is going to come from the user profile's email. The user nickname is going to come from the user profile nickname. The user photo is going to come from the user profile photo to display. Timestamp is going to come from up here. You have some special options. One of them is the current date time. So every time you add in a comment, it's going to write the row ID of the to-do into your to-do ID, the user profile's information into all of these, and the current date and time into the timestamp. And then once we've added a comment, we'll say comment added. Okay. So that's looking really good. So let's give it a test. The first thing we want to do is delete that. That's an empty row. Okay. So nothing yet. Where's that? So down here, you can even configure what the empty screen says. So let's say add the first, or be the first to comment. Okay, so let's test it. See if I've got this right first time. There we go. So Dad has said this is a test. And the important thing to do here is to get the filtering right. So we're wanting to filter here where the to-do ID is the screen's row ID. That way, we're not showing all the comments in the system on every to-do. We're filtering so that the right comments appear against the right to-do. Okay, so if we now view as, let's say, Emily, and add something in. Great. So we've got our comments flowing through now. But one thing we do need to quickly sort is what we're displaying. So the text is going to be the message. The timestamp is going to be the timestamp. The author's photo is going to be the user photo. So that's now pulling these through. The author's name is going to be the user nickname, which we have already. And the author email, and watch this. There we go. So in blue now, it's going to show who we're currently signed in as. So if I view as myself again, as Dad, there we go. So I can say, hey there. And then if I view as Josh, he can say, what's up? And suddenly we have an in-app chat just like that. So we can view again as myself, and suddenly we can see a conversation between everyone. So that's comments. And hopefully if we jump out of here and go into another one, so we don't see any comments here because we're filtering by the to-do ID. So now if we look at the comments database, we can see all of these have been added in. We're capturing all the information that we need to. So that's how to set up comments where people can now discuss things within a to-do. Okay, so we've now created a family to-do app that allows you to access and edit your profile, that allows you to see all to-dos that you have, both today and on other days, and that you've completed. And we've allowed for the ability to add them in and also to go and edit them and to click through to see more information, to complete them and to comment on them. And we've managed to do all of that in almost an hour, just over an hour. So pretty good going.
If you found this video useful and want to learn more, be sure to check out our full course where we dive deep into building and customizing apps with Glide and other no-code tools. It provides comprehensive tutorials and expert guidance to help you build professional-grade applications. If you're new here or if you haven't done so already, be sure to subscribe to the channel, like the video, share it with your friends, leave any questions that you have below, and we'll see you in the next video.